Hi, my name is Charlie. I'm a graduate student in Rahul Kohli's lab at the University of Pennsylvania School of Medicine. I study antibiotic resistance in bacteria, and currently I'm working on methods to combat antibiotic resistance and delay the acquisition of resistance in dangerous pathogens. I was born in China, and at the age of three, my parents and I, we left China and actually moved to Germany, in Munich. And in 2003, I came here to the States, and so that's when I started American high school and then went to college in the States. In Germany, I was actually kind of a mediocre student. Grades weren't that good. But then when I came here, I don't know why, but like somehow I just got really motivated. I guess the major difficulty during this period was actually the language. So having just moved here, I had no trouble really with the science, the math and stuff, but like for these writing intensive classes like AP European History or English literature, like it was a little bit more of a challenge. I took organic chemistry in college, because I registered as a biochem major, and that just really hooked me into science. I joined a lab in college, did almost 3 years of research in that lab, and that's really what kind of like sold me on becoming a researcher. Our lab is, I would say, medium-sized lab. We have roughly, give or take, 10 people, including rotation students. The people here come from very diverse backgrounds. Some people are full PhDs, other are MD PhDs, some people are veterinarians. Our professor is a physician scientist, so he has an MD PhD, and so he, in addition to doing research, he also sees clinics at the hospital. The atmosphere is incredibly collegial. It's a really teaching-oriented lab, so everyone helps each other out. Everyone is not afraid of asking questions. Whenever you have a problem, you can just go to your next door neighbor and just say, hey, I'm working on this problem, can you please help me out? So, it's a very collegial, very kind of like laid-back atmosphere. We joke around a lot, but we also do really good science. One major goal that I have, or I'd like to see this progress, is that, at this stage, we have a major problem in trying to combat antibiotic resistance organisms. And so what this lab does, we investigate alternative methods of combating antibiotic resistance. Specifically, we want to slow down the acquisition of resistance. When you look at old pictures of scientists, they're typically male, they're typically, white, that aspect of things has changed tremendously. I think nowadays science is an incredibly diverse field. You have people from all sorts of backgrounds. Just looking at our lab, people think that science is like very homogenous. All people are these sort of awkward, nerdy type people, and that's not true. The other misconception I'd like to address is that there's somehow this misconception out there that to be a scientist you have to be incredibly smart or like a super genius to like even make it, and that's also absolutely not true. Obviously, being smart is a plus, but there's so much more to that, persistence, hard work, creativity, and the ability to use your hands, which is something that many people don't appreciate. For a person who wants to get into science, they should be encouraged by this, because it's not like one single factor that determines whether or not you'll become a scientist or even do well in research. There are many different things. Approach a lab and then just ask if you can like spend some time working there, observe how scientists interact and work. I think that's an invaluable experience. It's certainly helped me, and I know of many others who has helped. The other thing about research, I just wanted to say that doing science and being like a working in a lab is not just sitting on a bench mindlessly doing experiments. There are many other aspects of doing science that can kind of like sometimes distract you a little bit from like occasional failures in the lab. A lot of people teach. In addition to that, you can go to talks, you write papers, you travel, and so, even though when things are not working, you have these other options of potentially taking your mind off like the the problem for a while, but then you can come back with renewed energy and so on. I think being a researcher is incredibly rewarding on many different aspects. First and foremost, you know, you get to work with some of the most amazing and talented individuals you'll ever meet. Second of all, you know, you get to expand human knowledge, and some of that human knowledge might be used to help other people, which is from sort of like a personal satisfaction point of view, it just feels good. And finally, you know, you get to do experiments, you get to, like, you know, try cool things, use techniques, operate interesting machines and stuff, and you get paid to do that. So, you know, if you like that kind of, you know, work and get paid for it, I mean, it's really the kind of like a great, like, career to have. And so I can only encourage people to try to get some lab experience, some research experience, and see if that is the type of sort of environment that they feel comfortable with. And if it does, that's great.